shortcuts that we can use for some tougher exponential problems. So just a review of working with exponents. And we're going to, instead of just figuring out right away what 2 to the third is, let's think about what 2 to the third means. Our base is 2 and our exponent's 3. So that means we take our base and multiply by itself whatever the exponent is. So the base of 2 times itself 3 times, which is 8. 2 to the third power is 8. So 3 to the fourth means 3 times itself 4 times. So that is 343. Now if you go straight from here to there, that's fine. Or if you use your calculator. But that's why we get that value. Let's look at negative values or negative bases. So here our base is a negative x. So we're taking negative x times negative x. And a negative times a negative is a positive. And x times x is x squared. So that's a positive x squared. Whereas here, our base is x. So we're taking x times itself. Then we have this multiplier of negative 1 out in front. So x times x is x squared. But that's multiplied by negative 1. So our final answer is negative x squared. So let's build upon those ideas to talk about the product of powers property. So let's skip the, this is like the generic rule. We'll come back to that. Let's look at x to the third times x to the fourth. Apparently that equals x to the seventh power. Can that really be true? Well, let's break down what x to the third means. That's x times x times x. Now that's getting multiplied by x to the fourth, which is x times x times x times x. Well, yeah, I suppose this is one large multiplication problem. The base is x, and we're multiplying x by itself a total of 7 times. So when we're multiplying powers that have the same base, we just add the exponents. We could have just done, well, I'm going to have 3 x's being multiplied together with another 4 x's. That's a total of 7 x's being multiplied together. Again, when your bases are the same, and that's an essential factor here, when the bases are the same and they're getting multiplied together, you just add the exponents. 3 plus 4 is 7. Now here, I call this sprinkling. Well, let's get to that in a second. Here we have x times x times x. But that's raised to the fourth power. So I'm going to take this times itself 4 times. 2, 3, 4. Well, really, the base is x, and I'm multiplying it by itself 12 times. So the trick here is when we have a power of a power, so here's a power, it's getting raised to a power, we multiply them together. 4 times 3 is 12. Here, a times b is getting raised to the mth power. Let's go over here instead. Here we have 3 times x times y raised to the second power. So that means 3xy, or 3 times x times y, times itself. Now here, this is all multiplication. The multiplication is commutative, so I can rearrange these things. So I really have, I'll use a different color here. I have 3 times 3 times x times x times y. What color should I use here? I'll have to repeat red. So I just rearranged the multiplication from this line right here and got this line. So I'm getting 9x squared times y squared. So really what happens here is we really I call it sprinkling. We really sprinkle that exponent to everything inside the parentheses. We don't just raise the y to the second power or exponentialize it. We also have to do everything inside of there. So here, the m gets sprinkled as an exponent to the bases of a and b. All right, let's try some applications here. So here, we have negative 5. That's our base, and that's raised to the second power. So it's the same as negative 5 times negative 5. That's a positive 25. Whereas here, our base is 5. We're raising it to the second power. But I have a negative out in front. So that's negative 25. So we'll try some numbers, and now let's go back to generic. Here we have negative x times itself. So a negative raised to an even power is always a positive. So we get x squared. Whereas here we get x squared with a negative out in front, so the negative comes along. And again, when raising a negative number to an even power, the result will be a positive. Kind of like how we say a negative times a negative is a positive. When that's an even number, the negatives will become positive. Whether it's two times that you're multiplying a negative together with itself, or four times, or six times, or eight times. Well, here, I need to sprinkle this exponent of 3 to everything inside the parentheses. So we have negative 7 to the third. That's going to be a negative number. I have a negative times a negative times a negative. That's a negative 343 times x to the third times y to the third. Let's look at this one here. We have negative 2xy. So I'm raising negative 2 to the 4th, x to the 4th, and y to the 4th. So this is really negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. That's a positive 16. Now x also gets raised to the 4th, and so does y. All right, here's some repeated multiplication. So here, I'm going to rewrite this and rearrange some things. So I'm going to just write the coefficients down first. This is all multiplication. Oops, I guess I put that one right there. So I have 2. That's a multiplier out in front, or a coefficient. You know what? If I want to put another one down, there's a 1 right in front of that x to the third. Now I'm going to write down the multiplication of our variables. So multiplying the values together, the coefficients together, I have 6. What's the exponent on this x right here? There's nothing up there. That's x to the 1 to the first power. And so now, to simplify this, I have 1x multiplied with 2x's that are getting multiplied together, multiplied with 3x's that are getting multiplied together. So I have 6x's getting multiplied together. That's x to the 6th. So my final answer is 6x to the 6th power. Holy schmoly. Now this looks similar to this, except for notice that this is getting raised to the 2nd power, and this is getting raised to the 3rd power. And thinking about our order of operations, we can't simplify anything in the parentheses right now, but we do have exponents. When we have an exponent to an exponent, we multiply those exponents together. So I sprinkle the power of 2 to everything inside of the parentheses. By the way, negative 2 squared is a positive 4. This becomes a to the 6th, and the exponent on this b right here is b to the 1. 1 times 2 is 2, so I have b to the 2nd power. Here, a negative 3 to an odd exponent is going to still be a negative, so that's negative 27. A to the 3rd, the a gets sprinkled with an exponent of 3. And then the b squared is raised to the 3rd power. We multiply exponents together. So we have b to the sixth power. Now, we can still simplify even further. We can multiply the numbers together. It's a negative 108. Now we're multiplying an a to the sixth with an a to the third. When we multiply bases that are the same, we add the exponents. So that's a to the ninth. And here we have a b squared times b to the sixth. That's b to the eighth. All right. I think these are the last two. Oh, pretty much. Then there's one little detail we'll talk about. So again, let's try putting all the rules together. We have an exponent to an exponent, so that gets sprinkled into the parentheses. So in that first parentheses, we have a negative x to the fifth, and that's raised to an odd power, so it's still going to stay negative. And if you want to put a negative 1 there and raise that to the third power, you can too, but otherwise it's like a negative x to the fifth. Well, that again stays negative since the exponent is odd. It's a negative times a negative times a negative. And then we have x to the 15. We multiply the exponents together. And here we'd have y to the sixth. In the second set of parentheses, I have 3 to the fourth. 3 times 3 times 3. It's 81. X to the 12th times y to the 16th. So we can multiply the numbers together. It's kind of like I have a negative 1 there. A negative 1 times 81 is negative 81. Then we're multiplying this all together, so I can multiply the same bases together. When I multiply the same bases together, I add the exponents, so I get x to the 27. 15 plus 12 times y. When I multiply the same bases together, I add the exponents, so that's y to the 22nd. Final answer. Last one like that. I bet you're feeling pretty good with these now, aren't you? So before we worry about sprinkling and multiplying the exponents together, realize I have negative x to the third to an even power. So that's going to become a positive x to the sixth power times y to the eighth power. Over here, I have a negative number to the third power. So that becomes a negative 3 to the third is 27 times x to the third times y to the sixth. So multiply our numbers together. It's kind of like I have a 1 out in front. So 1 times negative 27 is negative 27. X to the 6th times x to the 3rd is x to the 9th. Y to the 8th times y to the 6th. We add those exponents again. That's 14. Last little detail here. When we have x times, a 3 times 4, when we're multiplying these two things together, we can sprinkle the exponents. So this is really the same as 3 squared times 4 squared, which is 9 times 16, which is 144. Now, if you don't agree with that answer, you're not sure about that. So the sprinkling idea we've been doing, and it truly is true, but we could also think of that as 3 to the 4th times itself. 3 to the 4th, I misspoke there. We could really think of that as 3 times 4 times itself. So 3 times 4 times 3 times 4. And now if we simplify within the parentheses, we get 12 times 12. That's also 144. Now here, some students think, well, I'll just sprinkle here as well. But here, think about it. We have 3 plus 4 times itself. So it's really the same as 7 times 7. That is 49. Or we could simplify in the parentheses and we get 7 quantity squared, which means the same as 7 times.